Built as a project to relieve traffic congestion and offer commuters a more viable alternative to road transportation, the Gautrain is entering its next phase of its rail expansion plan.
Gautrain isn't actually a transport project. It's an economic investment project that just happens to move people. If we look at the Gautrain as it is at the moment, it's had more money put into the economy than was spent on it. And I think the ratio is around 2.60 of economic impact for every rand that was invested. So we're incredibly proud of that. So the extensions are about maintaining that momentum and keeping that economic impact. From a social point of view, also massive, massive benefits. You know, job creation. I think over 200,000 jobs being created in the construction period that we're envisaging. A lot of money that then goes down into local content, local businesses, black-owned businesses. So really, really big, big benefits. Then when we start talking about the operations, that's when the real social impacts start happening, because we start saving people an enormous amount of time getting to and from work. Our projections are that in 2037, the average travel speed on our freeways is, and wait for this, going to be 10 kilometers an hour. If we don't invest in rail, we're going to be stuck in our cars, in taxis, on roads. So we do a very strong rights of expropriation and something called proclamation under our legislation here in Gauteng, and we use that. What that means is that we can get rights over the property following a very fair public process, but we do get the land. Then any issues that any landowner has relates to how much they get compensated for that. So if we look at Gautrain as it is now, I think there were 1,400 properties that we needed to get access to, and I would say 1,100 of those, 1,200 of those, no issues. Agreements were signed, we got the properties and could start building. And the remainders, we obviously had some discussions with property owners. Those we couldn't negotiate with, unfortunately, have to go to some form of formal dispute resolution. But there is a process, and it works. It works well. Integration is ongoing. You know, our bus feeder system, it's 125 buses. It's not nearly enough for the area that we need to cover. So we keep looking at partnerships with other people. Certainly the BRT systems in Joburg and Tshwane. But there's another very exciting fine-tuning, if I can call it that, where we've started partnering with minibus taxi associations. Now, as it is, they're running 8 routes for us with MIDI buses. Those are 22-seaters that they own. We brand them in the Gautrain colors, but they run a scheduled service that is the best in the world. It runs on time, it's perfectly clean, safe and secure, and that's extended our footprint in terms of our feed and distribution service really well. There's this perception that somehow it's this fantastically rich upper income. It's not. We carry people who would otherwise be sitting in their starter car. You know, someone who's got a job, earning a little bit of money, enough to own a car, but doesn't really want to be in their car. So that is still going to be our target. But what we're doing in extending the network is reaching out into other areas. The ones that I think get the most media attention are, we're going to get to Soweto, we're going to get to Mamelodi, we're going to start bringing in people from areas that are much further away from the economic nodes than they are at the moment. But we're still going to target people who would otherwise go and waste their money on buying a car.
I'm Lisa Raleigh, and you're watching Joburg Today.